Good morning, good afternoon, good evening, everyone. Welcome to Kafka Summit. Today, we're going to do an interview with a special guest, technologist, a longtime Kafka user, Leon Stiehl from Citigroup. Leon, welcome.
Thank you for having me.
So before we talk about Citi, Leon, maybe you can start just by telling us a little bit about yourself and your personal journey of Apache Kafka.
Sure. I started with Kafka and Confluent, actually, about 8 years ago. I was at Credit Suisse at the time, looking after derivatives and risk for North America. And we were looking at data and how to combine data in intelligent ways. And after that, about 3 years ago, I moved over to Citigroup. And I'm using Kafka here, where I look after equity market making.
That's great. Now let's talk about Citi. Of course, you know, Citi is like a large organization with hundreds of thousands of people. What's like working at Citi? You know, what's the technology stack at Citi?
As you said, Citi is enormous. It's a large, large global bank. It's the definition of at scale. There are 97 offices, 73 trading floors, about $4 trillion worth of transactions are processed every day. And as you can imagine, in a large global organization, the technology really runs the gamut from large-scale systems to microservices to Kafka, message buses, REST APIs. We have a full spectrum of technology that we're using across the plant.
That's great. Okay, now let's get down a little bit to Kafka.
Sure.
Over the past years, you know, including Citi, you have worked probably with multiple like use cases of Apache Kafka. Now you have to pick one. What do you think is the most interesting use case that has the biggest business impact?
I think when you look at equities trading in an investment bank, you're dealing with data that's has different timing. So you have real-time data, stock prices, things that are ticking. You have data that's pretty static, terms and conditions, things like that. And then you have data that's updating periodically, things like position updates. So if you can use a tool like Kafka to pull all that data together and combine it in ways that you display to end users, whether they be traders, salespeople, managers, and you provide them analytics across that data, it's extremely powerful. And so I think the systems we built using that have really transformed the way people think about, you know, really what's possible.
Is there any like haha moment from like a business impact perspective?
Yeah, I think, you know, we took a report that somebody was receiving the next day, you know, and we were able to show them that updating in real time or near real time, you know, on a website. And I think they were able to manipulate the data. And I think when they think of they understand that you can do this now and the technology is there and it's there, it's at scale, I think you see a light bulb go off in their heads and they say, well, what else can you do? Can I get data from here? Can you combine this? Can you show me this? And it really changes the nature of the conversation.
Now, let's talk about just adopting the technology. You know, Citi, of course, you know, is a large enterprise, potentially with lots of legacy systems, right? So how easy it is to adopt like a new event streaming technology like a Kafka at Citi, you know, any resistance in particular that you have encountered?
Yeah, I think that's a good question. At any large organization, including Citi, you have senior technologists who are very thoughtful, smart, and opinionated, frankly. And when you discuss problems and solutions, they bring a wealth of experience to bear, which is obviously positive. But at least the discussions on why you chose the solution you chose. And, you know, if they don't have a frame of reference around event streaming architecture, it's a more challenging conversation. You know, you get questions like, why not just use REST APIs or why not use a message bus for this use case? And I think being able to have those conversations thoughtfully and respectfully is very important in a large organization as Citigroup. I think also Citigroup, you know, I said is the definition of being at scale. You know, by being that large and having financial regulations and around the globe, being able to manage data, federate data, put in proper security controls. It's not an environment where you can download a piece of software off the internet and just upload it and release it to production. You know, we have very careful and systematic approaches for doing production releases, and that can be challenging.
Yeah, so that sounds like the organizational resistance part. What about technical challenges? Anything that you have encountered that you have to overcome?
Yeah, when we were putting Kafka in initially, you know, we had challenges around sizing the environment, and we worked with Confluent on that. You know, using Zookeeper to right size our footprint, and then you know there were technical challenges in implementing it. For example, using Kubernetes with a cloud implementation of Kafka was more challenging than it seemed out of the box, and. You know, we worked on which versions should we be using, and really it was a lot of back and forth with Confluent to resolve some of those technical challenges. I spoke with some of my colleagues, and they had issues with connectors where, you know, there were security concerns around connectors, and they spoke with Confluent, and we worked together on patches for that to make sure, you know, everything could function at the scale and security level we require.
As good as you mentioned, the difficulties of managing Zookeeper. You know, the good news, you know, we have this KIP. You may be aware of KIP 500. We're in the process of removing the Zookeeper dependency within Kafka. So hopefully that will make Kafka in general easier to manage in the long term.
I think that approaches the holy grail of elasticity.
Yeah, so that's great.
I'm excited for that.
Now, let's talk about Kafka as a technology. So when you picked like Kafka as a message bus, right, within the city, there are, of course, you know, other choices. You know, what made Kafka appealing to you?
I think it's the right tool for the right problem. I think we do have message buses at Citi where, you know, there are use cases where that's appropriate. We do have REST APIs where that's appropriate. And I think what really worked well for us with Kafka is the ability to do analytics over a persistent amount of time. So it's not just a fire and forget message bus. It's not an intraday system where, you know, we can only look at today's data. We can actually keep a record of data on Kafka over a longer period of time, aggregate information and do analytics across, you know, multiple days. We can set how long we want to do that. And I think that was, you know, really effective at getting people to look at it differently.
Yeah. That's good. Now, if you look at the Kafka itself, right, it's a great technology, but I think for a lot of the companies adopting technology, you know, is not always easy because, you know, you need essentially build a solution out of that. So can you talk about what other things you have to do to make the adoption of a technology like Kafka successful within Citi?
Yeah, I think when you approach any organization, Citi, if you're a new joiner somewhere, or you have to look at the culture, and you can't come in and say, Kafka, 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 here's the solution. Let's go look for problems. You have to look at the problem thoughtfully. And, you know, I like to think of Kafka when I talk to technologists is, you know, we have databases, and everybody's familiar with the database. And at the core of a database is a log. And before it gets stored in a table, before anything happens, it's written to a log. And that log is distributed and has sophisticated ability to distribute that log over multiple sites, multiple instances. It's fault-tolerant, things like that. So it's keeping a record of everything that's happening. At the same time, you want to be able to access that log. So if you're at Citi or another large organization, you want that data recorded and you want that data accessible across your organization in a controlled way. So if you had that ability and you didn't have to go to a database and get an update and publish that update somewhere. It was just a log that's running. You have something powerful. Now, if you then take that log and add a pub/sub model to it, so I can subscribe to updates, I can publish updates, more similar to a traditional messaging bus. If you combine those two things, you have a really, really powerful tool. And I think, you know, when I talk to people about Kafka in the technology space, I like to orient them in that direction initially, so that we could then say, okay, this problem, you know, if it's low latency, fire and forget, intraday data, that's not the right use case for this. But if you're looking at, I want to do analytics across data, I want to combine different sources of data, you know, now you have a very, very powerful tool in your arsenal.
Yes, yeah, and that the central commit log, you know, has to be made really reliable, durable.
Yeah, I think if you think about Citigroup, you know, you have obligations to be present. So it's not, you know, a site where if you're down for a certain amount of time, customers understand. And, you know, you're dealing with financial regulated environments where uptime and resiliency really needs to be industrial strength and really fault tolerant. So getting that log capability in a way that's really been proven at scale over and over again across the industry is key.
Any advice to our audience? You know, a lot of them are technology leaders in their own organization. What can you say to them, you know, adopting this event-driven platform in their organization?
Yeah, I spoke a bit about people bringing a wealth of experience to the table. You know, I was thinking about this and I taught my son when he was very young string theory. And at the time I thought it was an experiment. Let's see what happens. Because it was very hard for me to understand string theory. And he immediately understood what I was talking about. And I thought it was very strange. And what I realized is it was so hard for me to understand because I had all this physics knowledge that I've accumulated through the years. So I was trying to understand it through that lens. And I think if you don't have that and you go directly to Kafka from not knowing anything, in some ways it's a lot easier to wrap your head around how it's different from other technology and what it can do. So I think to help with adoption, you have to be patient and respectful with people and understand that, you know, they've tried something before. I use this tool, I use this approach, it worked at scale, let me use it again. And to shift their thinking from everything at rest to everything at motion it's a journey. And, you know, at Citigroup, we started the journey many years ago. I helped organize with Confluent's help a conference call. It was an hour presentation on what is Kafka, what is it good for? And we sent it out to the community and over 900 people joined the session, you know, from around the world. We followed that up with a hands-on training for people, about 50 people from all different teams. And we, you know, got their hands dirty on a use case that was meaningful for their lives. So it was a financial use case. This is something that's relatable to what you're doing. And they were able to use Kafka in that session with Confluent team members around to be hands-on and to help them. So we kind of created, we did education in terms of reactive architecture, Kafka. We got people active using it. And we created this activity in the space. And then, you know, over time, different teams are using at Kafka and you're looking at your organization and you have a lot of Kafka in your space now. And then we began to think of things like Kafka as a service. So one of my colleagues, Lucian Hulata, is working on offering, you know, users at, in our development community, the ability to access Kafka for their applications really as an internal service. So, you know, and then as you're doing that, then you have to federate the data and have controls and proper things in place. So you could see how it started from, you know, hey guys, there's this technology out there. Let's think about the right use cases and educate you. To how do you solve using this at scale with hundreds of users? So that's really exciting.
That's good. Yeah, that's lots of like good advices there. Now, one last question. What's next? So what's next, you know, in your plate for you and your team?
So I think, you know, you touched upon it earlier, removing Zookeeper. If we're able to scale more elastically, you know, in a cloud environment, you know, Confluent Cloud is great. And I think that solves a public use case. At Citi, it's more, because of the nature of our data, it's more of a private cloud type of environment. So I'm keeping a close eye on Project Metamorphosis. So being able to set up cloud instances and our private VMs, private instances, and scale those linearly without Zookeeper as a gating factor, and going directly to something that's more cloud native is really something, you know, that we're keeping a close eye on. I think also just basic things like multi-region cluster failover support. We're looking forward to working closely with Confluent on that as we continue to expand.
That sounds good. Yeah, I think making Kafka more cloud native, making it more resilient across multiple regions, you know, these are the things a lot of other companies are also looking for. All right, Leon, hey, obviously, you know, you had lots of experience with Kafka. So if you have to pick like one use case, you know, one that's the most interesting and then also provides the biggest business impact, which one would you pick?
I think when you look at equities trading in a investment bank, you're dealing with data that has different timing. So you have real-time data, stock prices, things that are ticking. You have data that's pretty static, terms and conditions, things like that. And then you have data that's updating periodically, things like position updates. So if you can use a tool like Kafka to pull all that data together and combine it in ways that you display to end users, whether they be traders, salespeople, managers, and you provide them analytics across that data, it's extremely powerful. And so I think the systems we built using that have really transformed the way people think about, you know, really what's possible.
That sounds great. Is there any like haha moment from like a business impact perspective?
Yeah, I think, you know, we took a report that somebody was receiving the next day, you know, and we were able to show them that updating in real time or near real time, you know, on a website. And I think, and they were able to manipulate the data. And I think when they think of, when you, they understand that you can do this now and the technology is there and it's there, it's at scale, I think you see a light bulb go off in their heads and they say, well, what else can you do? Can I get data from here? Can you combine this? Can you show me this? And it really changes the nature of the conversation.
Yeah, that's great. Well, thank you a lot, Leon, for your time and your advice. It's a pleasure to have you here.
Thank you for having me.
Bye-bye.